Hey guys, this is Malinki. Welcome back to my channel, Voice of Malinki. Today I will talk about the Classical Genetics Lecture 2, and here we will discuss what is gene, allele, pseudo allele, multiple allele and locus. So first thing is gene here, and if you are new in my channel, please subscribe my channel, and if you like my video, please do like, comment and share my video. So gene is basically a portion of DNA. It is basically a portion of DNA. So we can see this is the DNA here, and this part of the DNA contains the gene. It is responsible for a particular trait of an organism. It is the unit of hereditary information, because it carries hereditary information and it is responsible for a particular character or particular trait of an organism. Next is alleles. So different versions of a gene are called alleles. So they are different forms or different versions of a same gene. They are different forms of a same gene. Example here is red flower color gene could have two versions. So the gene is red flower color gene. This is the gene, and it could have two versions. These two are alleles. Those are capital R and small r. So here we can see this is the pair of chromosome. Pair of chromosome, and here capital R allele is located and here small r allele is located. So these two are alleles. Each gene can have two or more alleles. So each gene can have two alleles or more alleles. In humans, everyone has two copies of each genes. Those are alleles. Two copies of each gene we have. An individual inherits two alleles for each gene, one from each parent. So this allele is inherited by the father, and this smaller allele is inherited by the mother. So an individual inherits two alleles for each gene, one from each parent. If the alleles of a gene are different, one allele will be expressed. It is the dominant allele. So if the gene contains two different alleles, one allele will be expressed, and that is the dominant allele. The effect of the other allele will be masked, and that is the recessive allele. So we will see this example. So here, red flower color gene contains capital R and small r alleles that we have seen in the picture. And R is, capital R is responsible for red color, and small r is responsible for white color. Here capital R will be expressed, small r will be masked, because capital R is the dominant allele, small r is the recessive allele. Therefore, the flower color could be red. The flower color would be red only. Next is multiple alleles. So when more than two alleles are present in one gene, more than two alleles are present in one gene, they are called multiple alleles. Multiple allelism is best described by the ABO blood group system in humans. There are three alleles of one gene. The gene is I here. It is I gene. Isohemagglutinin gene. Isohemagglutinin gene, that is the I gene. This gene contains three alleles, and this gene is in the ABO blood group system. So this gene contains three alleles. These three alleles are IA, IB and IO. So these are three alleles of gene I. That means they are multiple alleles, because this gene contains more than two alleles. Even though three alleles are possible of this gene, one individual would possess only two alleles, as humans contain only two sets of chromosome. That means a pair of each chromosome we have. Therefore, we have to have only two alleles of that gene, although it has three alleles. That means the combinations of the alleles would be either this one, that is IAIA, or IAIB, or IAIO, or IBIB, or IBIO, or IOIO. So these six types of combinations are possible here. Next is locus. So basically, a locus is the specific physical location of a gene. It is the specific physical location of a gene or other DNA sequence in a chromosome. So basically, it is a physical location. So in this picture, you can see in this chromosome, capital A gene is there, or you can say capital A allele is there. And this allele is present at this part of the chromosome. And that part of the chromosome is called locus. So that is locus. So locus, basically you can understand that locus comes from location. So you can understand the location of the gene or any other DNA sequence in a chromosome is locus. The plural of locus is loci. So sometimes you will see the word that is loci. So loci is basically the plural form of locus. Next is pseudoallele. So when two or more genes have functional similarity. So two or more genes have functional similarity and they behave like two or more alleles of the same gene, they are called pseudoalleles. So although they are different genes, but they have functional similarity and therefore they behave like the two or more alleles of the same genes. They are pseudoalleles. Generally, these pseudoalleles are located so close to one another on a chromosome that they are genetically linked. So these pseudoalleles are located so close to one another on a chromosome. That means they are genetically linked here. That means pseudoalleles are always inherited together. So they are always inherited together. The nearer two genes on a chromosome, the lower the chance of crossing over during meiosis. And the more likely they are to be inherited together because they are very near to each other. That's why they have very lower chance of crossing over during meiosis. That means they would be always inherited together. So in this diagram, you can see capital A and capital B genes are here. And in this chromosome, capital A and capital B genes are here. And these two are different genes. So capital A and capital B are different genes, but they are very closely related. And they are pseudoalleles here.